by the Holy Spirit. Resolved to sin no more, I humble myself at your most holy feet, O Jesus, my most merciful Redeemer. With sorrow for my sins, I ask your forgiveness with all my heart. And I love you above all things. Accompany me with your grace, O most loving Jesus. Enlighten my mind and soften my heart, so that by meditating on your most painful journey to Calvary, I may be filled with sorrow for my sins. By your suffering, by your blood, make me worthy to obtain by this devotion the indulgence granted, which I offer for the souls in purgatory. And my sweet Jesus, grant that in the way of the cross, I may learn to love you always. First station, Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My most amiable Jesus, you wish to die for me, and die with my sins, and that witness who accuses you, that judge who condemns you. How great, how ungrateful I have been. You have given me life, and I deliver you to death. I repent of my sins. I despise them, I detest them. And since you have not punished me by making me die on the cross, grant me at least the courage to accompany you in sorrow to Calvary. I love you, Jesus. I love above all things, and I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love your ways, and do with me what you will. Amen. The second station. Jesus receives the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My loving Jesus, you embrace the cross with meekness, and I with such diligence seek to avoid it. You humbly accept so great a weight, and I, full of pride, reject my own lesser cross. How blind I am. You teach me to suffer so that I may be saved, and I neglect my salvation because I do not wish to suffer. My dear Jesus, free me from self-love, and if the cross is the only way to heaven, here I am, ready to embrace it. Help me with your mercy. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love your ways, and do with me what you will. The third station. Jesus falls for the first time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My most amiable Jesus, fallen under the cross, stretched out on the ground. Angels of heaven, sustain your Creator and my Redeemer. Alas, instead of angels, the enraged scoundrels come running, and with punches, slaps, and kicks, beating for me. My dear Jesus, faced with so many outrages, you suffer and remain silent. Whereas, whenever some small evil strikes, I am shaken, At every offence I am resentful, become angry and complain. My most patient Jesus, lessen my pride, so that I may be with you until death. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant me may love your ways, and then do with me what you will. The fourth station, Jesus meets his sorrowful mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider the meeting of the Son and the Mother, which took place on this journey. Jesus and Mary looked at each other, and their looks became as so many arrows to wound those hearts which loved each other so tenderly. My most loving Jesus, by the sorrow you experienced in this meeting, grant me the grace and truly devoted love for your most holy mother. And you, my Queen, who were overwhelmed with sorrow, obtain for me, by your intercession, a continual and tender remembrance of the passion of your Son. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things, and I repent with my whole soul for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love your ways, and then do with me what you will. The fifth station, Simon of Cyrene, helps Jesus to carry the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider how his cruel tormentors, seeing that at each step Jesus from weakness was on the point of expiring, and fearing that he would die on the way when they wished him to die, the ignominious death of the cross, constrained Simon of Cyrene to carry the cross before our Lord. My most sweet Jesus, I will not refuse the cross as the Cyrenian did. I accept it. I embrace it. I accept in particular the death that you have destined for me, with all the pains which may accompany it. I unite it to your death. I offer it to you. You have died for love of me, and I will die for love of you and to please you. Help me by your grace. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things, and I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I love your ways, and then do with me what you will. Sixth station, Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider that the holy woman named Veronica, seeing Jesus so afflicted and his face bathed in sweat and blood, presented him with a towel with which he wiped his adorable face, leaving on it the impression of his holy countenance. My most beloved Jesus, your face was beautiful before, but in this journey it has lost all its beauty, and wounds and blood have disfigured it. Alas, my soul also was once beautiful, when it received your grace in baptism, but I have disfigured it since by my sins. You alone, my Redeemer, can restore it to its former beauty. Do this by your passion, and then do with me what you will. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things, and I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love your ways, and then do with me what you will. Seventh station, Jesus falls the second time. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider the second fall of Jesus under the cross, a fall which renews the pain of all the wounds of the head and members of our afflicted Lord. Our most gentle Jesus, how many times you have pardoned me, and how many times have I fallen again and begun again to offend you. And by the merits of this new fall, give me the necessary helps to persevere in your grace until death. Grant that in all temptations which assail me, I may always commend myself to you. Love you, Jesus, my love above all things, and I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. Jesus speaks to the daughters of Jerusalem. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider that those women wept with compassion at seeing Jesus in so pitiable a state, streaming with blood as he walked along. That Jesus said to them, "Weep not for me, but for your children." My Jesus, laden with sorrows, I weep for the offences that I have committed against you, because of the pains which they have deserved, and still more because of the displeasure which they have caused you, who have loved me so much. It is your love, more than the fear of hell, which causes me to weep for my sins. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things, and I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love your ways, and then do with me what you will. The ninth station. Jesus falls the third time. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider the third fall of Jesus Christ. His weakness was extreme, and the cruelty of his executioners was excessive, who tried to hasten his steps when he had scarcely strength to move. Ah, my outraged Jesus, by the merits of the weakness you suffered in going to Calvary, give me strength sufficient to conquer all human respect and all my wicked passions, which have led me to despise your friendship. love you, Jesus, my love above all things, and I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I love you always, and then do with me what you will. The 10th station, Jesus is stripped of his garments. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider the violence with which the executioner stripped Jesus. His inner garments adhered to his torn flesh, and they dragged them off so roughly that the skin came with them. Compassionate, your Saviour, thus cruelly treated. My innocent Jesus, by the merits of the torment that you have felt, help me to strip myself of all affection to things of earth, in order that I may place all my love in you, who are so worthy of my love. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things, and I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love your ways, and then do with me what you will. The 11th station, Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider that Jesus, after being thrown on the cross, extended his hands and offered to his eternal Father the sacrifice of his life for our salvation. Those barbarians fastened him with nails, and then, raising the cross, left him to die with anguish on that infamous gibbet. My Jesus, loaded with contempt, nail my heart to your feet, that it may ever remain there to love you, and nevermore to leave you. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love your ways, and then do with me what you will. The 12th station, Jesus dies on the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider how Jesus, after 3 hours' agony on the cross, consumed at length with anguish, abandoned himself to the weight of his body, bowed his head, and died. O my dying Jesus, I kiss devoutly the cross on which you died for love of me. I have merited by my sins to die a miserable death, but your death is my hope. Ah, by the merits of your death, give me grace to die, embracing your feet and burning with love of you. I commit my soul into your hands. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things, and I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. The 13th station, Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider that our Lord, having expired, two of his disciples, Joseph and Nicodemus, took him down from the cross and placed him in the arms of his afflicted mother, who received him with unutterable tenderness and pressed him to her bosom. O Mother of sorrow, for the love of this Son, accept me for your servant and pray to him for me. And you, my Redeemer, since you have died for me, permit me to love you, for I wish but you and nothing more. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always. And do with me what you will. The 14th station, Jesus is placed in the tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Consider that the disciples carried the body of Jesus to bury it, accompanied by his holy mother, who arranged it in the sepulchre with her own hands. They closed the tomb, and all came sorrowfully away. Ah, my buried Jesus, I kiss devoutly the stone that encloses you. But you rose again on the third day. I beseech you, by your resurrection, make me rise glorious with you at the last day, to be always united with you in heaven, to praise you and love you forever. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things, and I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love your ways. And then do with me what you will. Let us pray. And our Father, a Hail Mary and a glory be for the intentions of the Pope. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.